Is your bike handling bad? Do you face any wobbling at high speeds? Do you have a tight or loose handlebars? Do you have any sound at your front end of your bike? Then this is the right video for you. In this video, we're gonna watch how to replace a cone set bearing in this NS200. If you hear this kind of sound from your front end of the bike, or if you face any looseness up in the handlebars, then either your cone set needs adjustment or replacement. Another scenario, your handlebars are too tight. Either your cone set should be too tight. This has three cases inside. One, your cone set should be rusted. Two, your cone set ball should be cracked or damaged. Three, your cone set adjustment should be too tight. Like, share and subscribe to our channel. Starting off, we need to tear apart the entire front end of the bike to proceed with this maintenance. This includes your headlamps, your mudguards, your calipers, your forks to get access to your steering bearings or the cone set. I'm removing the headlamp connectors. The ABS wiring and your main console wires. This makes your headlamp free, assembly free. So we'll keep this aside. Removing the brake calipers using 12mm socket. Remove your ABS sensor lines if your bike is equipped with ABS unit. Removing the number plate clamp off. We need to disconnect all the wiring harnesses, which goes to your LH and RH switch clusters and your ignition socket. Make sure you note which connector goes where, such that while installing, you get to know which is which. We'll remove the wheels next. Use a 22mm spanner, a ring spanner specifically, to remove the wheel nuts. To support your bike while removing the wheels, keep a wooden block or a concrete block like this under your bike such that your front end is lifted up. After lifting off the front of the bike, remove your axle by pulling it gently out. Then your wheels should be off like this. We need to remove the mudguard by loosening up the four bolts which are present inside. Loosen up these two bolts using a 4mm Allen key. To remove the forks off of the bike, we need to loosen up the four pinch bolts and then we need to pull the forks off. These two are the pinch bolts at the bottom. Then we have two Allen keys over here and here. After loosening the four bolts, we'll just pull off the forks. Then we'll loosen up the top clamp bolt by using a 24mm socket. Next, we'll remove the top clamp with the handlebars just by wiggling it up. While holding the handlebar clamp assembly, just remove the headlamp stay. To loosen the cone set adjustment nut, we need a special C-spanner like this. This will be included in your toolkit. Then use the provided groove to lock with the nut right here and then loosen it up. After removing the cone set adjustment nut, we need to remove the dust seal. Ensure that this is in good shape. If not, replace it. This prevents water entry and dust entry inside your cone set assembly. Next step would be removing your T-clamp off the bike. You could see that the cone set is in a pretty bad condition where it's rusted and the grease is pretty much dried up. This is why your handlebars are pretty tight when your cone set is actually adjusted. This is a good time that you take care, you replace these bearings and the race which is present at your T-stem. We'll have a look at the upper races.
You could see that this is also in a pretty bad shape. We'll have a closer look at the race here. Clean the T-stem by using a hole rag. Remove all the grease and rust from it. We'll be needing a hammer and a punch like this, a solid axle or a punch like this.
To remove the bottom race from your bike's frame, you could see a groove at the bottom. Here is your bottom race pushed out from the top using this punch.
Use your hammer to remove the bottom race. Now that we have removed the bottom race from the frame, as you could see that the race is broken while removing, and you could see the damages in the race.
Now use a old rag to clean up the residual grease and rust from your bottom race seating area. Ensure that this is very much clean before you are installing your new conset.
Use the same punch and the same method to knock off the upper race, which is present here.
This is the upper race which will be present on your bike's frame. As you can see, this is in okay condition, but anyway, we are gonna replace this. Ensure you clean the seating area of your conset races in your frame. This enables us to easily install the new races back to the frame.
Now you can see the race seating area and the well inside is pretty much clean.
Conset race installer. This is used to actually install your conset races onto your seating area in the frame. This is nothing but a nut and a bolt with two machined guides. As you can see, these are the new consets. This is the upper bottom one and this is the upper one. I'm using a KTM branded part right here because NS200 KTMs share the same consets and the part number. Even Dominar and the new Adventure 390 has the same part. You could see these are two different consets right here. The blue colored part goes to your bottom part of the T-stem, that is your bottom part of your handlebar assembly, and the white colored ones right here, these go to your top part of your handlebar assembly. Add some grease before you install the race back into the provision in the frame.
If the seating part of your race in the frame is actually rusted like this, make sure you have some steel wool like this and then gently remove off the rust. Apply a thin layer of grease on the bottom side of the race installing provision.
As you can see, this is the new bottom race right here.
Slightly apply grease onto this. To install the bottom race, place the race in position and then slightly push it in.
Upper race right here, we are proceeding by applying a thin layer of grease. Give a gentle press to it.
Use the race installer's bottom half of the part. Install it like so. Then use the bottom half of the tool and the nut, guiding the bottom race like this.
Use a monkey plier. Tightening the bolt will make the race get installed on your bike's frame.
I'm giving a gentle tap right here.
This will help the race which is going inside to, you know, seat or seat to the right position or correct its position.
Loosen up the installing tool like so.
Ensure you remove the guides as well as the tool outside.
Ensure both the bottom and the upper races are properly installed onto your frame by gently using your finger to feel whether the gap is consistent or not. If the gap is non-consistent on any part of the seating area, then your conset race is not properly installed.
If found that your races are not properly installed, use the provided bushings, then use your hammer to gently tap and even out the insulation. as you could see that the bottom race is not properly in position. As you see that this area has, you know, more gap from here to here, and you could see that here the gap is pretty less. So the cone race is not properly installed right now. Make sure you use the same procedure. Keep the bushings on place and then tap out to even out the installation.
Ensure you just wipe off the excess installation grease.
Now we'll come on to the T-stem portion. Right here you could see there is another race on the bottom. This is in a pretty bad condition with all the pittings and rustings right here. Punch and the hammer mechanism to remove this off of the T-stem. This is your bottom race right here. As you can see, this is rusted. And this is your dust seals. And this is just a washer. Ensure you clean these seating surfaces. Apply some grease onto the bottom part of your T-stem. Then put back the seals. Apply some grease onto the bottom half of your race. To install the bottom race onto the T-clamp, tap at the opposite ends such that it enters into the provision evenly. We have installed the bottom race onto position. You could see here is your bottom race and here is your seal, and then here is your washer. We have this grease which is included in the cone set package. This is used to lubricate these bearings as well as these races. To pack grease onto the bearing first, to install the bearings onto the race, ensure that this curvature right here faces downwards. Squeeze out some more grease from the sachet provided such that you are packing the entire bearing and the race with adequate grease. Remember, excess quantity right here won't affect anything.
Go generous, then use your finger to pack the grease inside.
Apply the excess grease onto the T-stem like so, such that the exposed bits won't get rusted in the future. Apply some grease onto the race which is on the chassis.
Apply some grease onto the upper bearings like this. Ensure that the entire ball race is covered with the grease. Apply some grease onto the upper race. Make it even with your fingers. Install the top race such that your U curvature faces upwards. Apply some more grease onto the top race as well as your ice pack. Okay. Even it out with fingers. Install the upper part. Apply some grease onto the top. Wipe off the excess grease with finger.
Gently install your T-clamp onto position.
To proceed further, we will install the top weather protection or the top cap seal, and then followed by the adjuster nut. Hand tight it, and then use your C spanner. Never over tighten this. Right now I'm checking the free play as well as the free moment of left and right turn. As you can see, there is zero play.
Install the right forks into place first. Then gently tighten the pinch bolt onto position. Then install the left forks onto position.
Headlamp bushkit onto position like this. And then the headlamp bracket. So install this such that the narrower part always remains at the bottom part. This is the wider part and this is the bottom part. Install the metal part inside first, followed by the rubber. Same applies to the right side. And then we can install the handlebar, upper clamp and the handlebars. Then we'll install the torque nut. Install the connectors and the wiring onto position. We need to install our number plate bracket. Ensure your two wiring harnesses are inside the provided area
Then we have our 12 millimeter bolts right here. We'll install them in place. Now we are securing the cable guides onto position. So to align the fork legs onto position, loosen up the 17 millimeter bolts a bit. Make sure your forks are completely inside by just rotating them slightly. Then by holding the forks, just tighten the bolt back.
Now we'll use a 6 millimeter Allen key to tighten the upper clamps. Ensure you give enough torque to these bolts such that they clamp onto the fork well. Same applies to the LH side.
Right now I'm installing the headlamps back onto position. Slide the headlamps, push it inside firmly.
After installing the headlamps back into place, check whether your instrument console and all other electrical signaling function. Check your indicators, high beam, as well as your self motor. Check whether your kill switch is functional or not, and then you are good to go.
Now we are installing the wheels back on the right. Make sure your brake pads are up quite apart such that your disc gets correctly positioned. Install your dummy spacers on the LH side. Now we are installing the wheel axles. Install the washers back into place and then followed by the nut. Using a 22 millimeter spanner, tighten the bolt. If your other side bolt is rotating freely, use a 17 millimeter spanner to hold the bolt in place.
You could hear no noises, and you could see that the handlebars are moving pretty freely from end to end.
With the cone set replaced right now, I would recommend to check the free play as well as the cone set condition every 5000 kilometers. And then every 25,000 or 20,000, whichever, you know, you feel if your cone set is quite tight or, you know, it's making some knocking noise at the front, whichever you feel comfortable, go for an entire replacement. This would make your bike handle very much better when you're going or taking a high speed corner or a high speed stretch. Considering this is a performance motorcycle, we would not want to have any wobbles or, you know, any lagging in the handling department, such that it may cause a safety factor for us. If you like our content, please do subscribe to our channel. If you have any queries or, you know, a video recommendation, do let us know in the comment section below.